157 million years ago, a herd of small dinosaurs ran through the swamps of what would become the Shishuo Formation of western China. Unfortunately for them, though, they crossed paths with a much larger dinosaur, one which would eventually cause their demise, not because it was a larger dinosaur that was predating on them, but instead because it was a massive sauropod that changed the environment. Deep puddles caused by these sauropods eventually would fill with watery mud, and then would trap these smaller herbivores inside, and also eventually lead to the name, Limosaurus inextricabilis. Limosaurus has been found in multiple groups, with as many as 12 in just a single footprint, and the waters that were in these footprints, with all of the mud that was added in there, would eventually harden into dense rock, thus leading to the name, Limosaurus, meaning mud lizard, and inextricabilis, for the fact that it was hard to get out of the rock. With a maximum length of under 2 meters and very small four-fingered hands, Limosaurus wasn't able to get out of these deep pits that were caused by this sauropod. And so there they stayed for the next 157 million years. 157 million years ago was the Oxfordian stage of the late Jurassic, a time when the dinosaurs still hadn't quite diversified into all the forms we know today, especially in the theropods, which, for example, didn't have many of the forms that we know from the late Jurassic and the Cretaceous. Or at least not any dinosaurs that changed up their group's lifestyle outside of Limosaurus, really. And that's because Limosaurus is very easy to misplace when you just look at it on a surface level. As an adult, it would have had a toothless beak, so it would have been an herbivore, because the beak also wasn't very sharp. But looking at the hips, it was definitely a saurischian, and even a theropod based on the three toes that it had. So despite being an herbivore, it belonged to what is generally considered the meat-eating dinosaurs, even as far back as the early late Jurassic. And when we look at the overall Shinshugu formation, this actually makes a lot of sense because there's a lot of theropods that have been found in that formation, including animals like Quanlong, one of the first tyrannosaurs, as well as other early saurosaurs. And the saurosaurs actually evolved herbivory at least a few times, such as in the therizinosaurs, the ornithomimosaurs, and the oviraptorans. So it's certainly a behavior that isn't totally foreign to this group. But is Limosaurus one of those? No. One of the most major pieces of evidence that Limosaurus wasn't actually a saurosaur is that four-fingered hand I mentioned earlier. And that's because the saurosaurs, like all tetanurans, had three fingers, which means essentially Limosaurus could not have been a saurosaur. But it also means it couldn't have been a carnosaur, something more closely related to Allosaurus or even Sinoraptor, which does come from the same formation. So while there was a very diverse fauna of theropods in the Shinshugu formation, which would have absolutely predated on Limosaurus, Limosaurus still is not very closely related to any of them. Instead, it was closer related to what's essentially the black sheep family of the theropods, and that's the ceratosaurs. Now, before you type your comments talking about how the ceratosaurs are actually very well known, there's really only two that are particularly well known by the general public, at least to some level, and that's Ceratosaurus, because it's the namesake and one of the very famous dinosaurs from the Morrison Formation, and Carnotaurus, which is in part because it's often depicted in media, including recently Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. But this group is a lot more diverse than it's often given credit for, and a large part of that is because to an often forgotten family within this group, the Noasauridae, which did have some carnivorous representatives like Magiacosaurus within the subfamily Noasauridae, but also another subfamily, the Elaphrosaurs. Elaphrosaurinae was made up of animals like Elaphrosaurus, Limosaurus, and Huinkelsaurus. However, it does show that there was at least some diversity here. Despite this diversity, none of the animals I've mentioned, including the other more carnivorous relatives, actually lived in Asia, except for one which lived in India. However, India was floating in the middle of the ocean at this time, or still attached to Africa. So it's really not the same thing as an animal being there with its close relatives. Instead, Limosaurus was very much striking out on its own, separately from all of its close relatives. But being separated by physical distance from its closest relatives isn't the only reason that Limosaurus was still an outlier. It was also the earliest known theropod to evolve herbivory, meaning that while I did mention some of the saurosaurs would eventually evolve herbivory, they hadn't evolved it at this point. Instead, they evolved it later down the line in the Cretaceous. So Limosaurus was likely able to spread where it did when other ceratosaurs couldn't, because it wasn't competing with those other carnivorous and complex theropod faunas of Asia. Or at least, it wasn't competing with them when it was an adult. And the reason we can say this is because we have so many specimens that come from these essentially mud traps caused by these massive sauropods. Using growth stages, and essentially the smaller numbers are smaller growth stages, stages 1 to 3 still had teeth, while the larger stages 4 and 5 did not. And so we can see a progressive loss of teeth as the animal aged. Additionally, we can look at isotopes from these teeth to try and understand what the animal was eating. Essentially, when an animal selects a food source, that food gets incorporated into the body. And so what you can see happening in the teeth of these animals, essentially what prey or what plants they're feeding on selectively as they age. What the researchers found is, in general, stages 2 and 3 plot very wildly and broadly across this graph, and actually plot somewhat close to some of the theropod dinosaurs, but still somewhat close to the herbivorous dinosaurs within the same Shinchugu formation. This means they were probably intermediaries that were omnivorous. However, as we continue to look towards the more adult stages of Limosaurus's lifespan, especially looking at the bones of it, because that is another source for these isotopes, we can actually see that they do plot very well within the herbivorous lifestyle. So as they did age, they did become much more herbivorous. However, especially in the early stages, stage 1, they do plot very, very widely. So it's likely that when they were young, they were essentially eating whatever they could, which may have facilitated a fast growth rate. However, I did not find anything that suggested that specific histology work for essentially how quickly they would have grown has been done on these dinosaurs as of yet. And moving back to the arms and the hands, they were relatively small, which is something we see in a lot of the ceratosaurs. However, they also had those four fingers, which actually has some implications about how the hands of the birds may have evolved. Now, Limosaurus was absolutely not closely related to the birds. The birds were instead celurosaurian theropods, which I've already mentioned before when I talked about animals like Quanlong. The earliest dinosaurs and even the earliest theropods had five fingers. The celurosaurs had three fingers, and the birds, though they still kind of have three fingers, merged two of them together, which fused to help strengthen the wing. However, Limosaurus kind of fits in the middle of this with its four fingers, which means it could potentially tell us a lot about how bird wings actually evolved. There's essentially two ideas as to how this happened. The first idea is that with the digits being numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, that digits 5 and 4 reduced, leaving the three-fingered hand of the bird. The other idea is that digits 5 and 1 reduced, thus leaving the three-fingered hand of the bird. There's a lot of other genetics that are being researched to try and help test this idea, and so there's a lot to get into and nothing's been really conclusive. However, Limosaurus having just four digits does suggest at least a time period for that first digit loss. And that's because that digit should have been lost before Limosaurus and the ceratosaurs as a whole separated from the rest of the theropods, especially the tetanuran theropods, which would eventually lead to the celurosaurs and birds. Limosaurus may seem like a strange candidate to pick for this kind of study, especially over some of the other ceratosaurs, but it's actually one of the best, specifically because of how it was preserved. The muddy pits that it was entrapped in by these massive sauropods essentially preserved all of the bones as they were in life position, meaning that we have a very good understanding of what the hands of Limosaurus would have looked like. And that means we can start to try and apply different models of how bird wings evolved to understand how the theropods lost their fingers and eventually took flight. And this makes Limosaurus a great case study of how knowing what the hell something is can help us understand something even about modern groups. Hi everyone, thanks for watching. I'd like to thank the patrons for voting for that one. You know, it was a very interesting concept. I proposed this one because I knew there was some interesting stuff about it, but getting into it, there's a lot of really cool stuff about it. If you're interested in voting on what the next What the Hell Is This is going to be, you can check out the Patreon, which will be linked down below. Be safe. Take care. Wear a mask. Don't go extinct.